Con Marathon. Is this your game?
Okay. I missed my game.
How's it going?
Tell me about your games. Introduce yourself.
I'm Andy. Yep.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa. And yeah, this is our game. It's somewhat inspired by Takeshi's Castle, Micro Machines, Mario Kart, that kind of thing. And these two guys are absolutely killing it right now.
Except for me, who keeps on running into
the
So at the minute, I'm running through a temple in a kind of Kyoto inspired level. We've got different ones. We've got one set in supermarkets, another one set in the big cities, and there are all sorts of interesting and strange obstacles like these sweeping monks. This is where the monks file their tax returns. So
There's a thing about it. In Japan, the monk stands there with the begging bowl, and then a Mercedes comes and collects him after the day.
We don't have a Mercedes in here yet, but maybe we can have that in.
But I can tell you how to say
it. Okay.
That's what it is. I've seen it happen, but so you based it on modern day and
traditional.
Yeah,
we wanted to challenge ourselves from the point of view of designing the courses. I didn't want to go, here's a snow level and here's a lava level and here's some explosive barrels and stuff. Oh, and here's a shipping container level. Mm-hmm. We wanted to try and do something that is really recognizable as soon as you see it.
Mm-hmm.
From like point of view is I felt that was the right thing to do with the game, but also I wanted to really challenge the kind of conceptions of what levels are for myself, and just because it's tough to make a 7-minute long
level. Oh, no. How many levels?
We have 4 in the current version. There's going to be 8, and then there's 3 mini games that go along with that, and a story mode.
Okay.
So there's a ton of stuff, a ton of content. Unfortunately, we're missing sound at the minute because there's been a technical problem, but someone's bringing us some help soon on that. But we have a Japanese commentator.
Oh, that'd be awesome.
Part of our team, and
you need Takashi Kitano to proper.
Well, we couldn't quite afford that, so we ended up on Fiverr, and then he's part of the team now.
Awesome.
So he does Japanese and
English and Japanese commentary.
Yeah, so you can switch between the two commentaries.
And it'd be ace if you conquered Japan with this game.
It's we're out on early access already, and our sales are higher in Japan than anywhere else. So that was a little bit of a worry. It was like, how would you take it?
Yeah,
it's not meant in any offensive way. Obviously, mm-hmm. It's meant as a compliment to Japan, and it's kind of silly and wackiness.
Well, games are proper culture there, so they'll respect what you do.
Totally. And it feels there's an arcade feel to it as well that I thought that I would hope that they would, appreciate.
And a silliness.
Yeah.
And, they like their silliness, it's really cool, the silliness.
Absolutely. No. Japan is a really small Steam community compared to America or Western Europe. And so it was quite a surprise that that would be the biggest
market
for us, yeah. So we're very, very happy with that. It's excellent.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
I should check it out. So when's it coming out? It's already out.
Out on Steam, but it's coming to Xbox and other consoles later on in the year.
Okay. Yes. Now we will talk to this person, your colleague from Trailmakers.
Yes.
Our neighbours.
Neighbours.
Yeah. So this is Trailmakers, and it's
I forgot to say, arigato gozaimasu.
So cultured.